Hello everybody, so I'm going to present the our paper, Revisiting the Evaluation Protocol of Knowledge Graph Completion Methods for Link Prediction. I'm going to try to do this quick. So the idea of, we are working with knowledge graphs, and knowledge graphs are these days very popular, and the reason of the popularity is because, or mainly because of the their unsupervised construction. Okay, so basically there is usually natural language text, and then it is translated into a knowledge graph somehow. Because of this, or because of this process, there are usually issues on how the knowledge graph is built. Okay, so the idea is that we would like to actually refine the graph using artificial intelligence, using machine learning in this case. So once the graph is built, we would like to refine its content, its contents. So there are two ways, or there are two main tasks. We are link prediction, which means infer missing edges or knowledge that is not present in the graph, and then fact checking, which is trying to detect erroneous edges, so edges that are not really true. So in this case, in this talk, I'm going to focus on link prediction. So let's talk a little bit about how the training works on these machine learning models. So first of all, is that the idea is that there are a set of knowledge graphs usually available out there, and then these are already split, or these splits are already provided. So as in traditional settings, so we are going to have training, validation, and test, usually 80%, 10%, and 10%. And the idea is that these are constructed by random selection of edges. So you take one edge, then you add it to the training, and then so on and so forth. So once this is done, the training actually happens using positive and negative edges. So positive edges are those that are actually in the graph, and then negative edges are those that are not in the graph. Okay. And generally, the idea is that we would like to have that Marie Curie and citizen of, it's a near neighbor of France, which is made, it's because it's positive. And then Marie Curie and citizen of should not be, or should be far away from Poland and USA and so on, because these are negatives. There are different ways to generate these negatives, but the most popular one is the local closed wall assumption. In this case, what we take is that we take the subject, or the object, in this case it's going to be the subject, which is the node in the vertex in the left side, and then we actually exchange that vertex for all the other vertices that are in the graph, okay? And then supposedly this is positive, and then all of these are expected to be negatives. As you can see, some of them can be more plausible, and then some others are basically nonsensical, like polonium actually got the Nobel Physics Award, or United Kingdom got the Nobel Physics Award. So the result of this process is a model which takes as input these edges in the graph, and then it outputs a score. We are assuming that the score closer to zero it's better, and a score closer to one it's worse. So the idea obviously is that then, because this one, the score is 0.05, so we are pretty sure that this is true, and then because this is pretty close to this, the score of this one is pretty close to one, we are pretty sure that this is not true, or this is actually negative. This is the how the training works in these models. Now let's see how the models are actually evaluated. So the evaluation protocol takes exactly like this. So we take the subject in this case, and we take all the vertices, and then we compute all the positive negatives, similar as before. Okay, so we get the positive, and then we get all the negatives derived from this one. And then what we do is that we rank them. So we take the model, and then we compute all the scores of these guys. And then we now rank them based on the score. Again, zero, it's best in this case, okay? And then what do we do? So, okay, so this one was the most plausible one, then this one is the second one, and so on and so forth. And then the result is that the rank of the subject in this going to be will be second. Why? Because the one that is actually positive was ranked second in this case. So the evaluation protocol now takes all these ranks, and then it computes all the ranks for all the positive triples when the subject and the object, so left and right nodes, are changed. And now we use this set of ranks to compute metrics. So the metrics, the typical ones are mean rank, which is basically the average of all these ranks, the mean reciprocal rank, which is the one divided by the rank, the average of that, and then hits at k, usually k is equal to 10, in which is this formula over here. So if the rank is among the first 10, it's a hit. Otherwise, it's a miss. So it's 1 or 0. So that's pretty much the protocol right now. So we have re-examined the protocol or this what has been done so far in these 3 ways. So we are going to talk about the splits, metrics, and anomalies. So first of all, we realize that random splits may be harmful. So this is just an illustrative example. Let's assume that we have this original knowledge graph in which we have 5 papers. And then we have the authors of those papers, so in total 5 papers and 10 authors, okay, and see that the original graph is pretty much exactly 2 authors per paper and so on and so forth. And now let's take just a couple of edges out of this, so those will actually be validation or test, and this is now the new training. So now check that the graphs are pretty much different, right? In the sense that now there are authors with no papers, and there are papers with no authors, and there is a paper that has only 1 author. So basically the original topology or the original shape of the graph has been changed because of this. So what we say that these random splits are actually harmful. So what we suggest or what we propose is that we propose a downscaling algorithm with statistical guarantees. So the idea is that we are not going to remove these edges by random, but what we are going to do is that we are going to try to preserve the indegrees and outdegrees of the nodes in the original graph. So the idea is that those indegrees and outdegrees will be a statistical distribution, and then we are going to analyze whether or not the sample of indegrees or outdegrees before the removal and after the removal are statistically significant, or basically we can say that they are statistically the same. For this we use the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test, and the idea is that the original indegrees, for instance, these are the ones, the new indegrees, these will be the ones, these are treated as samples, and then we use Kolmogorov-Smirnov with significant level of 0.05 to actually check whether or not these indegrees are the same, and similar for the outdegrees. If we do this for every single triple, and then the result is that the indegrees and the outdegrees are preserved, meaning that they are coming from the same distribution, we actually remove that edge and we put it in either the validation or the test. Otherwise, the edge is not removed. So then the idea is that we are trying to keep the same indegrees and outdegrees, which hopefully will actually give us the same cardinalities or similar cardinalities of the predicates at the end of the process. So we have been also re-examining the metrics. So there are issues with the current metrics. This is by others, not by us. In which in some cases the differences between the values are not there. Like for instance, in the mean rank, there is no difference between 1 minus 1 divided by 2 and 1 divided by 2 minus 1 divided by infinite. So basically both differences are exactly the same. So similar to hits at k and so on. These are not having differences between the values is not good. And it is also, there is a controversy also whether you can actually compute the mean of an ordinal scale. It is mathematically possible but semantically incorrect. So this is actually related to the MRR as well. In our case, we also see that every measurement of these metrics that we have presented before, they are usually upper bounded by the same constant value, which, for instance, can be the total number of documents in the search engine. These are coming from the information retrieval world, and this is basically the maximum number here. The problem is that in our case, the number of negative counterparts is different. So when you provide a positive triple, the number of negative counterparts, it's different depending on how many subjects or objects you can actually exchange. So in the paper we analyze three metrics. So we analyze the regular arithmetic mean rank, we analyze the geometric mean rank, and we analyze a weighted geometric mean rank in which we take the number of negatives into account. Okay, so the idea is that all of this will be mean ranks, but we are actually using, or we are actually going to analyze these three different options. Finally, regarding anomalies, there are issues with the current data sets that are out there to check link prediction. And this again is our others. So there is anomalies are unrealistic, is unrealistic data redundancy. So for instance, many triples of the type subject predicate object, they have either another predicate in which they are same or inverse same, meaning that it's the same subject object or reverse. So pretty much, if there is a model that every time that sees a predicate like this predicts something like that, it is pretty easy to, or it's considered an easy predicate. So this allegedly simplifies the task. So these are easy predictions, but we're going to see later that that's not actually the case. So we say also that the removal of these anomalies is harmful. So right now, in the current data sets, these anomalies are completely removed. The problem also is that if you do that first, the topology of the graph is changed, and then the size of the training split is reduced, and the removal is also based on a user threshold. So it is also unclear whether if that threshold changes, how that affects the final process. So in our case, what we propose is that instead of actually removing them, what we propose is actually taking them into account inside the protocol. That means that for each triple, we actually have an anomaly coefficient related to it. And then these triples are grouped by quartile. So Q1 will be those that are expected to be easy, and Q4 will be those that are expected to be hard. And then Q2 and Q3 are in the middle. So basically, there will be some triples that belong here, and these are expected to be easy. Some triples that will be here are expected to be hard. And then these are a little bit more difficult, but not so difficult. And then these are a little bit more difficult, and so on. So basically, in increasing difficulty level. So what are the results that we are having? So the results, I am only focusing on the freebase ones, but in the paper we have also four more additional data sets. So what we are showing here is we are actually showing the mean rank, the geometric mean rank, and the weighted geometric mean rank. And then in this case, these are adjusted, which means that if it is closer to one, it's better. If it is zero, they are in this, the model is indistinguishable from a random model. And then if it is minus one, it means that it's actually worse than random model. So then, as you can see, the arithmetic mean rank in some cases, like for instance in this case in Transi, so it gets to 0.9 something, but then the geometric mean rank it's actually get to 0.99, but then the weighted geometric mean rank it gets also to 0.99, but a little bit higher than that. And this is because the number of negatives in FB13 changes. Also, this is not FB13, it's FB13 prime, which is the new splits that we have computed. We have also included AMI, which is a rule mining algorithm, and then we are also comparing AMI with respect to the other models as well. So in general, what we can see is that the trans D, E, and H models are usually having the highest accuracy. And then in the other models, there are, depending on the metric, there are some of them that actually have better accuracy than others. We are actually using here the OpenK implementations of these models. We also did the accuracy by quartiles. So in this case, we are focusing on the weighted geometric mean rank. And then again, Q1 is expected to be easy and Q4 is expected to be very hard. And as you can see, some of the trans models, this is actually not really the case, in the sense that there is pretty much no difference between all of them in this case. And you can see also, like for instance, in this mold, it's actually the other way around. So Q1, which is expected to be difficult, is actually having worse results than Q4, which is expected to be hard. It is true that for AMI, these are usually fulfilled. Okay. So, the conclusions are if those anomalies actually, the impact of the anomalies are on the rule mining ones rather than on the machine learning ones, because these are, as it can be seen, having different results than expected. We also analyzed ties and scores that were tied or scores that were below expected, basically worse than random. And we see that, for instance, AMI has a lot of these, especially because of the way that we construct that we compute these scores. But then we can see also that the other models, the ties are almost non-existent, and then the ranks below, in some cases, there are a certain percentage of triples, positive triples, that the rank is below expected. But in some others, that in the trans models, this percentage is also nothing. So this is like 2%, 3%, which is usually pretty good, right? So conclusions, we have been, our contributions is that we have been talking about, or we have been contributed to splits, metrics, and anomalies. And then our results differ from current work significantly, in the sense that we have been studying the mean rank in these different ways. We have also these new splits and the whole evaluation protocol. And the idea also of this paper is to try to have the community investigating these new ways that we are proposing in the paper. Thank you so much.